Good evening, A.V. Graham graduates, parents, families, guests, and staff. My name is Mrs. Hoffman Sartor, and I am the vice principal, the very proud vice principal of A.V. Graham School, and I'm your masters of ceremonies this evening. We are thrilled to have so many of you watching us live from your living rooms, your garages, your front porches, wherever it may be. We're so happy you could join us this evening. We're honored, and you should be honored, to represent and enjoy this wonderful evening, celebrating an outstanding group of grade eights.
We acknowledge that we are on the land surrounded by water, originally inhabited by Indigenous peoples who have traveled this area since time immemorial. This territory is within lands honored by the Wampum Treaties, agreements between the Anishinaabe, Haudenosaunee, Lenni Lenape, and allied nations to peacefully share and care for the resources around the Great Lakes. Specifically, we would like to acknowledge the presence of the Three Fires Confederacy, Ojibwe, Odawa, Potawatomi, and Huron-Wendat peoples. We are dedicated to honoring Indigenous history and culture while remaining committed to moving forward respectfully with all First Nations, Inuit, and Métis.
Graduates, families, friends, staff, it is my pleasure and honor to be able to address you this evening on behalf of the Board of Trustees. All of my colleagues and I would, of course, prefer to be with you in person for this occasion. However, I know that you understand why that's not possible right now. I hope you also appreciate, as we do, the effort of your school community to create this presentation to acknowledge, at this time, the class of 2020. This has been a difficult period for everyone, students, their families, teachers, and administrators. It has been, in every way, a crisis but not a catastrophe. We have, with the highest intention and incredible creativity, continued to provide high-quality educational opportunities in as manageable a format as possible. I am proud that we have shown and seen exceptional strength, fortitude, and resilience. But that is merely my perspective. The most important assessment, however, should be your own. How did you perform as an individual, as a citizen, as a student? This should not just be applicable to the past few months, though. Your greatest, your most sincere responsibility should always be to yourself during an emergency, as well as each and every day. We are marking your achievements in school to date. So I hope you smiled today and said, well done. You have made it through these past few months, but more significantly, you have endured all kinds of different tests over your years in school. You may not have chosen all these challenges, but you have accepted them and done what was required to succeed. I urge you to use the experience, recent and former, to continue to strive and to achieve. I look forward to the opportunity of congratulating you face to face at the appropriate time and in the appropriate fashion. Congratulations, and I wish you much success in your future. Thank you very much.
Students, families, friends, staff, we've been through a lot in the past few months. No one could have imagined how one tiny organism could have altered so much in our lives. How we interact with one another, how we behave on a day-to-day basis, how we teach, and how we learn. But COVID-19 has changed many things, possibly forever. This emergency has also caused us to discover a great many things about ourselves, good things, such as our immense capacity for respect, empathy, and how we can succeed independently. Until recently, the changes you were most concerned about would be typical for grade eights: a new school, new teachers, new friends, and new educational challenges. 6 months ago, I would have recommended that you embrace those developments and genuinely enjoy the adventure. Today, I'm inclined to temper that advice, to be cautious and deliberate about the fresh demands you will face. However, you need not fear change of any kind, whether it's going to high school or tremendous societal upheaval that we are now experiencing. As communities and as individuals, we've done exceptional things to deal with what we have been required to endure. You have been well prepared for anything that may happen in high school and in your lives as adults. I am very proud of the way we have accepted recent events, adapted, and overcome our struggles. I think it's a reflection of many of the things that you've learned in elementary school, knowledge and skills that just can't be measured by a grade. The people who are now saving lives, working on vaccines, and developing safeguards for future possibilities were once where you are now. There was likely something that happened to them when they were your age that was the inspiration for what they are doing now. Change is a fact of life. Don't allow any disappointments you've experienced recently to influence your outlook. You are ready to start making a difference in the world, and you can't do that with a pessimistic attitude. Be positive, be encouraging, and be safe. I'm looking forward to learning about everything you discover and witnessing the changes you bring about in high school and in your communities. Congratulations.
Noor has many great memories at AV Graham and will miss everyone a lot. He is looking forward to all the sports offered in high school, specifically basketball, and he's excited for the new experiences he will have. Sarah has really enjoyed elementary school. Her special memories include playing the drums and how kind everyone was. She is ambitious and plans to improve her English and learn to play the violin. Charlotte's favorite memory of elementary school was the grade 7 trip to Camp Winona. When quarantine is over, Charlotte is looking forward to seeing her friends and playing hockey again. Lily has had a great experience these past years. One of her favorite memories was going to Camp Winona with all the other grade 7s. After quarantine, she hopes to go visit friends and family she hasn't seen since the virus. She also hopes to go on a vacation. Emily hopes to have plans of traveling the world. She hopes someday to visit Italy, South Korea, Thailand, and many other places. She dreams of becoming a baker or a school teacher someday. Emily is an honor roll recipient. Trenton's favorite memory was making gift baskets for the homeless shelter and people in need. His future aspirations are to continue to study mathematics and to pursue a career as a stockbroker. Thomas's favorite part of elementary school was participating in Slamma Lamma Jamma at DM Eagle. In the future, he looks forward to attending university to pursue the sciences. Thomas is an honor roll recipient. During her time at AVG, Ava really enjoyed participating on sports teams with her friends. She hopes to become a successful neurologist in the future. Ava is an honor roll recipient.
Jesse's future plans are to expand his lawn care and landscape business. The first thing Jesse wants to do after social distancing measures are taken down is go to his family's cottage in Michigan. Sam remembers having a great time at Camp Winona, and he aspires to study science to be a botanist. Emilio's favorite elementary school memory was playing sports with his friends at recess and on teams. His future aspiration is to do well in high school so that he can study a good profession. Emilio is an honor roll recipient. Aurora's favorite memory in elementary school was when her current best friend asked her to be friends. She is so grateful they are friends. Once quarantine is done, the first thing she is going to do is see all of her family. She is also looking forward to a vacation with family. When Sophia is older, she wants to be either an interior or exterior designer. And after quarantine, she is going to get a smoothie at Urban Surf and go to the mall. Hannah has wonderful memories of competing in track and field and cross-country events over the years. In the future, she plans on attending university and working in the medical field. Hannah is an honor roll recipient. At this point in time, Aeneas aspires to become a high school math and physical education teacher. He cannot wait to spend time with his extended family after quarantine. Aeneas is an honor roll recipient. Jana remembers the friends she gained in school and is looking forward to finding more friends and getting to expand her knowledge. Dylan's favorite memory of elementary school is going on the Camp Winona trip in grade 7. Dylan wants to become an artist in the future. Chloe wants to go to university to study history. She'd like to learn more about the Tudor period in England. Phoebe can't wait for the upcoming events in high school. After quarantine, she wants to hang out with her friends and family. Phoebe is an honor roll recipient. Olivia is eager for quarantine to be over so she can take a trip to California with her family. Playing hot potato with the whole volleyball team and Fun Bun Friday were two of her favorite grade school moments. Olivia is an honor roll recipient. Liliana attended A.B. Graham this year and has loved meeting all the staff and students. When she is older, she hopes to pursue a career in optometry. Liliana is an honor roll recipient. Chloe's fondest memories of A.B. Graham including establishing friendships at Camp Winona, sports team spirit days, performing group dances, and having dedicated and inspiring teachers. In the fall, Chloe will be attending the E-STEAM program at Tecumseh Vista. Chloe is an honor roll recipient. Adriana's favorite memory at A.V. Graham was the softball tournament in grade 7. In the future, Adriana would like to go to medical school to become a doctor because she likes saving people. Jasleen is looking forward to being part of the eSTEAM secondary program and can't wait to hang out with her friends after quarantine. Jasleen is an honor roll recipient. Parsdeep's favorite memory of elementary school is her entire grade 6 year, as she cherished and appreciated the welcoming environment of DM Eagle. Parsdeep's future aspirations are to continue expanding her knowledge about the world and doing well in school. Parsdeep is an honor roll recipient. Prabhjot's favorite memory is that he made so many new friends at school. The first thing he wants to do after quarantine is to go to the beach and swim. Kaylin is a proud graduate of A.V. Graham. Marco's favorite memory of elementary school was when he won the Mathematics Achievement Award in the 6th grade. The first thing Marco plans to do after quarantine is to go to the park and play basketball with his friends. Marco is an honor roll recipient. Stefan's fondest memories of elementary school was when he went to Camp Winona and learned and experienced new things there. Stefan's first thing he will do after quarantine is get together with his friends. Stefan is an honor roll recipient. Jack's favorite memory of elementary school was graduation day at DM Eagle, when everyone lined the hallways and the grads high-fived their way out of the school. The first thing Jack is excited to do after quarantine is to go on vacation with his family to Hawaii to surf the waves. Mateo plans to take a trip when this quarantine is over. He is looking forward to seeing his friends and starting high school in the fall, where he hopes to concentrate on his studies and one day become an engineer. Mateo is an honor roll recipient. Adam's favorite memory from grade school was when he went to Muskoka Woods with his friends. The first thing that Adam wants to do after quarantine is to have a big sleepover with all of his friends. Kareem's favorite memory about elementary school was going on the Muskoka trip in grade 7 with his friends because he made lots of fun memories. The first thing Kareem will do after quarantine is go to the mall with his friends. Chloe is thankful for the time and family she gained at A.B. Graham. She is looking forward to grade 9 and to becoming a stronger as a person. Faith's favorite memory in grade 8 is when she performed her Christmas dances and lip-sync battles and having the opportunity to play piano in front of the school. Hannah's favorite memory was making bags of ice in the office with her friends. Her current aspiration in life is to open a bakery shop. Arnie's favorite elementary school memory was going to Camp Winona in grade 7. When the pandemic is over, the first thing Arnie will do is go to the movies with his friends. Arnie is an honor roll recipient. Ryan enjoyed his time at DM Eagle and at AV Graham. He fondly remembers sports events, field trips, and Camp Winona. In the future, he would like to become a pro scooter rider or an entrepreneur. He is looking forward to tackling high school at TVA. Ryan is an honor roll recipient. The first thing Grace will do after quarantine is hang out with her friends and catch up with everyone. She is really looking forward to singing and perfecting her acting skills in the future. And she plans to work harder to reach her goals. Nimish's favorite memory of elementary school was playing wall ball before it got banned. The first thing Nimish is going to do after quarantine is go outside. Nimish is an honor roll recipient. Diljot's future plan is to go to a university and be a cardiac surgeon. The first thing she's going to do after quarantine is meet with her friends. Bryce Goldhawk is a graduate of AV Graham. Connor is looking forward to his first year in eSTEAM at Vista and hopes this will lead him to an engineering career. He is looking forward to spending time with friends and family when quarantine is over. Connor is an honor roll recipient. Emerson is looking forward to hanging out with her friends after quarantine. A favorite school memory of Everson's is when she came in third place and her team got first place in cross country. Vivi aspires to become a veterinarian in the future. She strongly remembers spending grades 5 and 6 in the portables at DM Eagle. Vivi is an honor roll recipient. Jake's favorite memory of elementary school is the Camp Winona trip in grade 7. The first thing Jake wants to do after quarantine is to get back to playing soccer. Jake is an honor roll recipient. Vanessa came to AV Graham in grade 7, which was a difficult time since she had to make new friends. But now she couldn't be happier. Vanessa is looking forward to going to Canada's Wonderland when quarantine is over with her family and friends. Vanessa is an honor roll recipient. Arbreet's favorite memory of elementary school was learning new things in all subject areas. Arbreet is excited to be making new friends in high school. Kyla's favorite memory of elementary school was going to Camp Winona. The first thing she will do after quarantine is hang out with friends. Jack will be attending the IB program at Riverside Secondary School and is planning on becoming an engineer. The first thing he wants to do after quarantine is get a haircut. Ryan cheerfully remembers Mr. Boy in a Bruins jersey. After quarantine, Ryan is excited to watch the NHL playoffs. A Sim's favorite memory of elementary school is hanging out with his friends. A Sim hopes to be a doctor when he grows up. Marcus's favorite memory in elementary school was when he walked down the main hall of Diem Eagle in front of the whole school. The first thing that Marcus will do after being quarantined is he will spend quality time with his friends. Satish's favorite memory of elementary school was when he went to Camp Winona. He really enjoyed the activities, but what was most valuable to him was making many new friends. Satish's future aspirations are to attend Riverside Secondary School and to specialize in math and science. Satish is an honor roll recipient. Through her years in elementary school, Ava acquired many fond memories. One that stood out the most was the Camp Winona trip. After high school, she plans on attending university and hopes to obtain a profession in the medical field. Ava is an honor roll recipient. Anthony's favorite memory was his first week of grade 3 in the Sir class. He is looking forward to his first year at St. Joe's High School. Hargis is eager to pursue the engineering part of eSteam to achieve his goal of becoming a mechanical engineer. He is eagerly waiting to hang out with his friends and misses going on vacation with his family. Harjas is an honor roll recipient. Ella's favorite grade school memory is coming to A.B. Graham and meeting so many new awesome friends and kind staff members. She is looking forward to graduating high school and studying dermatology. Ella is an honor roll recipient. Kelton aspires to be a professional photographer. The first thing he will do after quarantine is go camping with his family. Cheers to the best 10 years of Larson's life. She will never forget it. Ryan's favorite memory of A.V. Graham is Camp Winona and all the friendships he formed and strengthened there. He plans to go to the University of Windsor and study to be a lawyer. Ryan is an honor roll recipient. Mila's favorite memory from elementary school is when she graduated from grade 6 at Diem Eagle and got to walk down the Walk of Fame along with her classmates. The first thing Mila will do after quarantine is see all of her friends and family. Mila is an honor roll recipient. Emily's favorite memory from elementary school is in grade 6 when her class and another class had a potluck. The first thing Emily will do after quarantine is hang out with friends and travel. Anna's first wish after quarantine is to hang out and laugh with her friends. Anna's future plans include going to medical school in the hopes of becoming a veterinarian. Anna is an honor roll recipient. Caden's favorite memory of elementary school was placing fourth in the 4x100 relay race at the 2019 district track meet. The first thing Caden is excited to do after quarantine is to attend a professional hockey or football game with other devoted fans. Caden is an honor roll recipient. Tegan's favorite memory from elementary school was lunchtime because she got to hang out with her friends and get a break from learning. After quarantine, Tegan plans to hang out with her friends and go to the beach, as she is excited to get back to the real world. In the future, Malia plans to be a lawyer or a business owner. Once quarantine is over, she is excited to see her friends. Malia is an honor roll recipient. Luke's favorite memory of elementary was going to Camp Winona. The first thing he is going to do after quarantine is go to his family's cottage in Grand Bend. Grant's favorite memory of elementary school is the last day of grade 6, walking down the main hallway, exiting that school for the last time. Also, making the start of a new chapter in his life. The first thing Grant will do after quarantine is hang out with friends and enjoy the summer before starting high school. Isabel's favorite memories from elementary school are all the amazing and fun teachers she had throughout the time, which made school 10 times better. Her future aspirations are to own an architecture and interior design business and live in Grand Haven, Michigan. In the future years, Matea hopes to study astronomy at university. After lockdowns are lifted, Matea wishes to reconnect with his friends and begin practicing soccer again with his teammates. Matea is an honor roll recipient. The first thing Isaiah is going to do after quarantine is hang out with friends and go to the mall. His future plan is to do better in school and be on the basketball team in high school. Kyle's favorite memory of AVG was going to Camp Winona with his classmates. Kyle will be attending Tecumseh Vista in the eSTEAM program and hopes to study computer science. Kyle is an honor roll recipient. As soon as quarantine ends, Dylan will be back out and about partying and having a good time enjoying his summer. Dylan hopes to become a neurologist and accomplish other great things in his time. Dylan is an honor roll recipient. Talia's favorite memory of elementary school is of grade 5 when her teacher would let them out of school early to go tobogganing as a class. After quarantine, the first thing she would like to do is visit her grandparents. Talia is an honor roll recipient. Rylan was a new Griffin this year at AV Graham. He enjoyed meeting many friends and learning while he was there. Natalie came to AV Graham in grade 3, and her favorite memories were being on the skipping and badminton teams. Her future goals are to work hard in school to become an optometrist. Natalie is an honor roll recipient. Emily is a proud graduate of AV Graham. Daniel is a proud graduate of AV Graham. Reese's favorite memory is playing football in grade 6 at recess, and his plans for life are to play football or to become a police officer. Gianmarco fondly remembers the great time he had at Camp Winona, and he is looking forward to interacting with the grade 9s at Vista next year. Ella's favorite school memory was Camp Winona, and her future aspirations and plans are to really work on music. Allison wants to get a scholarship and attend the University of Gulf Coast, Florida, and study marine biology and become a high-level competitive swimmer. Audrey's favorite grade school memory was being with old classmates and meeting new friends on the Camp Winona trip. In her future, she wants to finish her education and find a job she is passionate about. Andriana is an honor roll recipient. When Jazz is older, she wants to become a child youth worker so she can help children who grow up in broken homes. After quarantine, she is most looking forward to going to the gym and seeing her friends. James's favorite memory of elementary school is when they were at Camp Winona and the cabin antics with his friends. James's goals include to have a profession in medicine, particularly surgery. His number one goal is to achieve a job where he can help people. James is an honor roll recipient. Ella's favorite memory was going to AVG and meeting so many amazing friends along the way. Ella also loved the fun field trip she got to go on with her classmates. Her favorite trip was Camp Winona. Serena has had some amazing memories from her time in school so far, but her favorite would be her trip to Lakewood Park, where she was able to rock climb, have ice cream, and sit by the water. She cannot wait for quarantine to be over so that she can spend time with her friends and family again. Serena is an honor roll recipient. Leah's favorite memory of elementary school was Camp Winona. She aspires to become a comic writer and creator. The first thing Elia is going to do after quarantine is have a lot of friends over. His plan for the future is to continue growing and learning. Elia is an honor roll recipient. Ryder is a proud AVG graduate. In September, Julia plans on participating in Tecumseh Vista's eSTEAM program, following the medical science strand. Julia's favorite memory from grade school were the yearly track and field meets. Julia is an honor roll recipient. Kaylee's future aspirations are to become a pediatrician, and her favorite memory from elementary school was when she went to Camp Winona. Elena really liked all the intermediate teachers and music class. Cameron's favorite school memory was the trip to Camp Winona. His plans after quarantine include hanging out with friends and family. Cameron is an honor roll recipient. Eden's favorite memory of elementary school is when she finally got up in front of the class and sang a song. Eden's future plan is to go to teachers' college and become a special needs teacher. will be visiting his friends and getting caught up on their lives after quarantine. The first thing Tyler is looking forward to doing after quarantine is going back on the ice to play hockey. His favorite elementary school memory was placing first overall in regionals and second overall in district track and field. Tyler is an honor roll recipient. Amir's favorite memory of elementary school was in grade 7 when he got his Gauss scores back and found out that he had done very well. After quarantine is over, the first thing Amir is going to do is visit some friends. Amir is an honor roll recipient.
The Music Award is handed to students who have ceaselessly spent time in the music room working on their craft and have kept it part of their extracurricular activities. The Music Award goes to The Boy, Ryan Gaduri, and then The Girl, Eden Jaworski.
The Excellence en Français Award is being given to a student who has excelled in all aspects of the French language. This includes reading, writing, and speaking. This student has maintained a high overall mark in French, demonstrating excellent and exceptional skill. Félicitations à Grace Gaston. Congratulations, Grace.
It is my sincere pleasure to present this year's School Spirit Award to a very deserving grade 8 student. This student is a true griffin in every sense of the word. He consistently demonstrates citizenship by eagerly offering to assist his fellow students, teachers, administration, and support staff alike. His school spirit is infectious. He participated in every single special day at A.V. Graham and has even been seen wearing a green tutu on occasion. There is no doubt that this individual is a positive, contributing member of our school community, demonstrating enthusiasm, helpfulness, and empathy. The School Spirit Award goes to a wonderful role model, Trenton Bayshard. Congratulations, Trenton.
It is my honor to present the Perseverance Award tonight. This award is for a student who always shared a positive outlook and demonstrated a spirit in influencing students as a role model. Personally, as the vice principal of A.V. Graham, this student has really given me a good understanding of race relationships and how to present in a beautiful, diverse community that we call A.V. Graham. Elena Williams, congratulations, dear. Good evening. I'm here to present the Kendall Hebert Award for Leadership. This student's leadership is among their peers and always contributes in such a positive way, and a wonderful student at A.V. Graham. I'm proud to present this award to Sophia Caron. Congratulations, Sophia.
There are students who demonstrate their strength of character in quiet ways, who show compassion and kindness in such ways that others can draw from this positive energy simply by being in their presence. A student who demonstrates commitment to their studies and personal growth, even during challenging times, such as these present-day circumstances. On the field or court, the student perseveres and maintains a winning attitude, sustaining belief in their teammates, and showing respect for all players. The Bryce Mamo Memorial Award is bestowed to a student who demonstrates the qualities of academic excellence, athletic prowess, and exemplary citizenship. These qualities were reflected in Bryce, in whose name this award is presented. Congratulations, Mila Kubik.
These students displayed positive personal qualities such as cooperation, effort, perseverance, and academic qualities within their programs. I'm honored to present this award, the Council for Exceptional Children, to Kelton Clay, Sam Burke, and Abrit Hans.
I'm presenting the award for Most Dedicated Male Athlete. This award is given to the student that excelled in dedication, leadership, and sportsmanship. This year we have two recipients. Both of these students displayed all of the above qualities on multiple sports teams over the last 2 years. Not only have they played all of the same sports at AV Graham together, they are also twins. I would like to congratulate Adam and Kareem El Mukdad.
The Francis J. McMullen Award is given to the female athlete who demonstrates dedication, leadership, and sportsmanship, combined with a high level of athletic ability. Being chosen for this award is a great honor because it means that your coaches recognize your drive. They see the way you interact with your teammates and how you intrinsically motivate yourself as well as those around you. Your coaches have seen you work hard, play hard, and end every practice with a thank you. Chloe DeMartin, we have seen you display all of these qualities and more, and it is my great pleasure to honor you with this award for the most dedicated athlete. Congratulations.
I'm presenting the Male Athletic Excellence Award. This award is given to the student who has excelled in overall athletic talent, dedication, leadership, and sportsmanship. This student has displayed his versatile athletic talent and his never give up attitude on many AV Graham teams over the last 2 years. I would like to congratulate Torek Zabian.
This award for athletic excellence is given to the female athlete that displays just that, athletic excellence. But you cannot be an excellent athlete in team sports without also being dedicated, being a leader, being driven, and being coachable. I first saw this athlete in grade 6 casually playing volleyball with her dad after one of our home games, and I knew that she was going to come to AV Graham and make an impact, and she sure did. This blonde tornado, as I used to call her in volleyball, is a force to be reckoned with. It could be a championship game or just a fun day of spike ball in gym class, and her level of enthusiasm and her love of sport is always the same. Combine that drive with some incredible skill and Olivia Cruikshanks, I cannot wait to see where your passion for sport takes you in high school and to watch you succeed in whatever you choose to play there. It is my pleasure to award you, Olivia, the Michael Patterson Award for Athletic Excellence. Congratulations.
Tecumseh Vista Academy Future Leader Award recipient has demonstrated leadership through the past 2 years he has attended AV Graham. This student attended leadership camp in grade 7 and was very successful with his Youth Thrive creation and presentation. This year's student was actively involved in the leadership team and showed his desire and commitment to being a leader in the school community. We believe this student will continue to eagerly participate in leadership opportunities throughout his years at Tecumseh Vista Academy. This year's male recipient of the Tecumseh Vista Future Leader Award is Nimish Gira. Congratulations. The The female recipient of the Tecumseh Vista Future Leader Award is described as someone who is quiet and dependable. She displays maturity and a willingness to help in whatever way she is able. She is respectful, responsible, and an independent person. All of these qualities combined to make her a strong leader within the classroom and the AVG community. We believe this person will continue to demonstrate excellent leadership as she continues her educational journey in high school at Tecumseh Vista Academy. Please join us in congratulating Vanessa Hamoli as the 2020 TVA Future Leader.
Good evening. For those of you who I have not had the pleasure of meeting in person, my name is Susan Moroz. I'm the very proud principal of A.V. Graham School. Tonight, I am going to start off by giving the Marsha's Unsung Hero Award. This award is presented to a grade 8 student who embodies Marsha Terlikas' legacy. The student is generous, supportive, compassionate, and humbly dedicated to making a difference in the A.V. Graham community. She is the type of student who is never threatened by the success of others, but rather can be found in their corner, cheering them on, genuinely thrilled for their success. Mr. Terlikas, who sponsors this award, has made a donation in the recipient's name to Hospice of Windsor, so it makes this award even more special. Congratulations, Talia Olson. Our final award this evening is the Ontario Principals Council Award. This award is sponsored by the Ontario Principals Council and is bestowed upon students who demonstrate exemplary leadership. The recipient tonight took on an important public relations role for the school and made it her own. She took the initiative to raise the school profile within the community by being a regular school correspondent for the Shoreline. Thanks to her initiative, A.V. Graham was well featured, and personally, I appreciated that she could be completely independent and reliable in her submissions. Thank you, and congratulations to Julia Van Nuy.
We are now asking our grade 8 classroom teachers to come forward to present their classroom awards. Congratulations, grade 8 students, as your teacher has specifically selected you because you have represented your peers in the classroom in the most highest regard. Congratulations.
The General Proficiency Award is given to the top overall students in all of our classes. These students are well-rounded, possess strong perseverance, work ethic, and take pride in their work. These students support their peers in the classroom. The recipients are Phoebe Chu, Thomas Perez, and Anais C.
Most dedicated student. These students consistently put forth a strong effort in all tasks. They are committed to making our classrooms an exciting place to learn. These dedicated students participate consistently, focusing on celebrating classroom success. They possess a strong work ethic and complete all tasks with exceptional effort. Congratulations, Jack Hatch, Matea Mitrovic, and Tyler Zanuto.
The Math Award is presented to the students in each class who love problem solving and being challenged. They are the leaders of our math classes. They actively participate during lessons and persevere to find the solution to all problems, no matter how difficult. These students are role models by always challenging their peers and demonstrate exceptional math proficiency. Congratulations to Arnie Firth, Marco Disick, Stefan Disick, and Kyle Nguyen.
The Language Award is given to students who are creative in reading, writing, and oral tasks. They demonstrate a commitment to media tasks and a love of language. These students are always looking for ways to improve their language skills. The winners are Serena Tatla, Vivi Hager, and Ryan Krall.
The Arts Award. The Art Award is bestowed upon the student who demonstrates outstanding performance in the arts, including music, visual arts, drama, and dance. Congratulations to Hannah Carroll, Liliana Doss, and Leah Torres.
The University of Windsor Alumni Association Award recognizes outstanding overall academic achievement. This year, it is presented to students who show exceptional pride in all the work that they do, are intrinsically motivated to succeed, and show tremendous curiosity to grow and learn as a student. They are academic leaders in all subject areas. Congratulations to Ava Jovanovsky, Dylan Chana, Caden Lewis, Natalie Patterson, Jake Hales, and Hargis Kara.
The following students are being recognized by the University of Windsor for academic excellence in French studies. These students are from Ms. Kirchang's class, Amir Zagangshin and Satish Jabal. Congratulations. From Ms. McGregor's class, we have Malia Lubak and Anna Lewandowski. And from Mr. Taylor's class, Cameron Worley and Emilio Calito Martel. Felicitations.
The Classroom Citizen Award is given to students who demonstrate excellence in the areas of citizenship, school, and community involvement. They have helped to make our classrooms a better place. The winners are Asim Iskander, Ella Karitsis, and Jack Dobrowski.
It is my privilege to present the valedictorians for this year's Grade 8 graduating class. These two individuals have demonstrated many leadership skills during their time as students at AV Graham. As active leaders, they have inspired their classmates, teachers, administrators, and younger students who look up to them. They are dedicated students, charismatic leaders, and exhibit all characteristics of what it means to be a true AV Graham Griffin. It is my pleasure to introduce this year's valedictorians, Trenton Bayshard and Nimish Guerra.
Good evening, honored guests, family, friends, staff, and most importantly, the Grade 8 graduates. We are honored to be standing in front of you today, even if we're just talking to a camera. We would like to thank the AV Graham staff and administration for helping us get to this point in our education, and all the challenges and successes they've helped us struggle through. We would also like to thank our families, who have not only raised us, but has made us the people we are today.
To share a quote, "The distance doesn't matter if the roots of your relationship are strong enough." During the COVID-19 pandemic, we have still kept our bonds with each other, even during these difficult and confusing times. Let's look at the ways. Our teachers have continued to provide us with unrecognized guidance and have not hesitated to keep us on the right track for high school. During the last part of the year, we have faced many hardships with the sudden quarantine, yet we have persevered to keep our relationship strong and education active.
Even though we faced a lot of hardships, we've also had somewhat a blessing in disguise with quarantine. It is helping us on learning how to adapt to different situations. For example, not being able to ask your teacher for guidance all the time, even discovering new hidden talents with this free time.
Some of us have refined our cooking abilities, or some of us have gotten better at art, music, or even video games. We have been forced to independently problem solve when in situations we could have asked help for because there wasn't a teacher or adult only steps away. Every kind of situation, good or bad, has some sort of positive or negative light to it. Quarantine gave us all a reset button. It gave us a chance to create a better version of ourselves. by improving our personal growth.
The first chapter of our school life has come to an end. The road we've all been on for these last 10 years is coming to an end, and it gives us an opportunity to reflect. This journey has taken us on all kinds of adventures. When the D'Amigo kids joined AV Graham last year, it was wonderful to have our Griffin family grow. Together, we have created so many memories, beginning with the Griffin Cup and Camp Winona.
These experiences quickly solidified our new Griffin family relationships. We have also been fortunate to have others join the family through the activities we shared in grade 7 and 8, clubs, sports teams, spirit days, leadership opportunities, Vista Cup, and even Shadow Day. We have continued to build special relationships and wonderful bonds.
We can only control what happens in the present, but we know we will have each other to see us through, for continued support, and to keep our spirits strong. As our speech comes to an end, we would like to thank the teachers and parents that have helped us through these difficult times. Their guidance has helped us stand as a whole and graduate together as stronger people today than we were at the start of the school year.
Congratulations, class of 2020. We're not ready for whatever the future holds for us. To quote the American poet Robert Frost, we leave you with this: the only way through is out.
Today, we are incredibly proud of all of you. Throughout the year, although there were three grade 8 classes, we as teachers got to know all of you through leadership and our Super 8 days. Your elementary years were filled with many friendships, leadership opportunities, activity days, sports teams, dances, clubs, classroom learning, and school assemblies. You are special to all of the AV Graham staff. We realize that this ceremony is a different one than the one you expected. And our hopes are that you can focus on what is today, a celebration of your accomplishments all throughout your elementary years.
This year was not one we expected and was filled with many examples of some of the challenges that you are going to face in the coming years. There will be times of hardships and disappointment, and you will learn and grow from each and every one of them. A wise person once said that what you practice, you become. Always remember to practice new things. Get involved in situations where you feel uncomfortable. Put yourself out there. Meet new people. Work hard in your studies. And always be kind to everyone.
We are so excited for you to begin your journey to high school. We know that you have so many adventures and exciting memories waiting for you. Remember to value, cherish, and thank the people who have made a difference in your lives along the way. Griffins, we will miss seeing your faces in the hallways of AV Graham. Good luck to you, and remember to always be awesome. Congratulations, graduates.
Before I make closing remarks for this evening, I would like to thank all of the graduation volunteers for all their work in creating this unique and wonderful ceremony. To our graduates, right now, I'm imagining all of you dressed up in your finest clothing with your fresh haircuts and your tottering high heels. Let me tell you, you all look great to me. And now I have the honor of doing closing remarks, and I have chosen a poem to do so. The Unity Poem. I dreamed I stood in a studio and watched two sculptors there. The clay they used was a young child's mind, and they fashioned it with care. One was the teacher. The tools he used were books and music and art. The other was a parent with guiding hand and gentle, loving heart. Day after day, the teacher toiled with touch that was deft and sure, while the parent labored by his side and polished and smoothed over. And when at last their task was done, they were proud of what they had wrought, for the things they had molded into the child could never be sold or bought. And each agree they would have failed if each had worked alone, for behind the parent stood the school
and behind the teacher, the home. To all of our parent partners, thank you so much for trusting us with your precious gift in allowing us the honor of being part of your child's life. To our graduates, best wishes and congratulations. And now, stay tuned for some grade 8 graduate fun. Enjoy!
It's like 25 to life, so you bust out of prison. Something's in the air, something's in the air. It's like that feeling when you're just about to kill it. Take your last shot, you know you're gonna hit it. Something's in the air, something's in the air. Whoa. Something big, I feel it happening. Out of my control. Pushing, pulling, and it's grabbing me. Feel it in my bones like, oh, whoa. Settle. Hands are in the air, hands are in the air. When they hear you when you thought they wouldn't listen, it's like an anthem that the whole world's singing. Hands are in the air, hands are in the air. Whoa. Something big, I feel it happening. Out of my control. Pushing, pulling, and it's grabbing me. Feel it in my bones like, oh, whoa. Shake. If we clap our hands, the walls will break. Yo, so loud, won't forget our names. Cause something big is happening. Take this rock and start a fire. Raise this up, we're feeling high. They can't tell us anything. Something big is happening. Something big, I feel it happening. Out of my control. Pushing, pulling, and it's grabbing me. Feel it in my bones like, oh, whoa.
Despite the challenge, all you gotta do is leave it better than you found it. It's gonna get difficult to stand, but hold your balance. I just say whatever, cause there is no way you're round it. Cause everyone falls down sometimes, but you just gotta know it'll all be fine. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Walk around the neighborhood, feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. Hey. Some days you wake up and nothing works, you feel surrounded. Gotta give your feet some gravity to get you grounded. Keep good things inside your ears just like the waves and sound it. And just say whatever, cause there is no way you're grounded. Everyone falls down sometimes, but you just gotta know it'll all be fine. It's okay. It's okay. their best. They feeling good, like I should. Winning the war around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed, never stressed.